Hi friends, this is Sadiq. Today I am going to demonstrate you Mule OAuth2 provider configuration using Mule4 component. Preparing this video as I have received a number of requests and help from the forum guys, from friends that I need to provide some kind of demo would be helpful for them to implement in their product or any demo. So right now I have prepared one OAuth 2 provider using Mule4 component. So let's go, and I hope you guys remember that last year I have prepared OAuth 2 configuration in Mule3. So this time I am sharing in using Mule4 components. I have prepared one OAuth 2 provider, and let me show you the configuration which I have done. This is the OAuth 2.0 provider using Mule4 component. You can see the version is 4.2.0.1. So if you go to the global configuration, you will find very helpful here, that very easy. We should have a thank to the Mule4 that they the number of steps they have reduced to configure OAuth 2.0 in Mule4, and they have really simplified all the steps, and no need to memorize the multiple steps and come back one place to go to the other place to configure the OAuth 2.0. You can see that only single single component is there, and we can configure with the authorize, and we can token path and scope, all we can configure here. The scope default and grant type, all I have referred from the property file. You can see dev.property.yml file, and same the security manager for both the owner and security I have referred here. Same I have configured in the property file, in the another flow file. You can see the security manager both I have configured in the resource, and if you go to the another one, it's the client. Okay, rest I have configured the object store as the simple object store. I referred to the configured object store, that is the client object store, and same it is the authorization object store, token object store, and refresh token object store I have all configured. This is the environment variable, and this is the property file configuration. Nothing else I have done over here. Another thing, the configuration is done with the bean. If you can see, this is a simple configuration, resource owner and client, and the authentication and the configuration I have referred both over here, resource owner and client user service. This is the simple one. We can configure, definitely we can play with that, but this is just demo, so I have given you one idea that how to configure it in Mule4. The same bean has been referred in the Spring, the common configuration bean, and this all the respective manager has been configured in the OAuth component. Okay, so let's go and check the supported grant type. Although I am sharing this code in my GitHub repository, you can go here and GitHub Sadiq Tech Mule4 OAuth provider. I have committed this code over here. You can go through here and can get the project. Let me go to the dev. We can see that supported grant type. I have configured all the grant type here, which we have. I have and scope I read write and read by default I read given, and token path I given access hyphen token. You can go and get what is the kind of grant type should be there, and scope what should be configured based on requirement. You can get the details from the document, Mule4 documentation. So I am deploying this application in my cloud hub environment. Let's go and deploy the application. Okay, let me go to here and I will configure. Okay. Remember client ID and client secret. What you are providing here should be from the owner. Okay. Let's go to let's deploy once. Okay, till the time it's deploying, let's go to the configure the API. Okay, so I have designed one API, that is the sample API, and sample API I just have one resource, get filter and employee, and that's configure the JSON. Okay, and this is the auth policy, security schema I have configured, that the header is threading authorization, and the URL for the auth provider I have configured here, authorization and access token. Okay, the same application I have referred in API manager. You can see that right now I have deleted that one right now, but you can see let me go here. You can see that client version 1.0.1, which I have published in Exchange. You can go, let me go to the Exchange. Okay, you can go to sample API. I have exposed over here. You can see the version 1.0.1, and I have get the I made the request. I have configured. Let me go over here. You can see this is the Exchange application I have assigned. This is my sample API. Okay, I got the client ID and secret. Now once I got the client ID and secret. Then I have imported this application in my studio and configure the discovery, auto discovery. I have configured the auto discovery. Let me go and deploy this application as well. Okay, this application deployed. Okay, let me go and deploy this application as well. I have deployed the auth provider. Now I am deploying the application with the auth configuration of the authorization and the token to validate to get the token. Let's go and check the auth provider. Okay, the access for the API which I have got, okay, the access for the API which I have got is this this client ID and secret. I am using the same client ID and secret to get the token. Let me make a request. I got the token. It's working fine. Okay, so let's see deploy the application once. So we can access the application resources. let me pause the recording. We'll be back once it deployed. Because it's taking time to deploy right now. Let's see, the application has been deployed here. Let's try this application first without token. I am here right now. Let me access this application without token. Okay, I have not configured anything. Make a request. Access token was not provided. Let's go and provide the token now. We got token over here. You are able to access the resource. If I change anything in token, I change from A to B. Authorized token. Okay, you got a point. So it's very easy. Steps has been shared and simplified the steps by Mule4. So it is very approachable and very easy to configure. Definitely, I have shared the Mule4 auth provider code in my GitHub repository. You can download from there. It's public. It does not have any restriction. So that's it. We'll share another video regarding another policies as receive many requests. Thanks. Let me know if any confusion or any point I need to clarify. Share your comments in video. Thanks.